Hi, my name is Anupam Bansal. I'm a practicing architect out of Delhi, and thank you to this college for inviting me for the fourth year jury, which is focusing on Ayanagar as a settlement in Delhi, and we are looking at different aspects of housing in settlements, and it's quite a fun day, yeah.
Thank you. Anupam, could you share with us two key features of your practice?
So we are about a 22-year-old practice, and our practice is basically comprising of me and my classmate Rajesh. We started the practice in 96, and we kind of focus a lot on doing institutions, and over the years, for last about 22 years, we've been working on a diverse scale of institutions ranging from research and development laboratories, schools, colleges. Now we are doing a university in Delhi. So, you know, we try to look at institutions from the point of some kind of a cultural asset, some kind of a resource for society, some kind of a place where people go for learning, people go and come together, because this is really, institutions are the hotbed of ideas, it is the hotbeds of innovation. So it's very exciting to work on institutions, and we try to look at typologies of institutions, we try to look at how relationships between inhabitants of an institution can be established, and also look at, particularly now in the context of all that is happening in our cities, in the entire world, we also try to look at, you know, how we can make our campuses more sustainable, how we can make campuses which are very, very low on consumption of water, very low on consumption of electricity. So try to make as much as possible sustainable campuses. And yeah, that's what we are focusing on for the past few years.
Great, thanks. What are your views on the state of architectural education in India today?
So that's a really tough question and could take a whole day. It really requires a symposium. But offhand, I can say that architecture education has kind of become a bit fixed and kind of rigid. And I think with institutions like these, you know, we should kind of start to look at how our core structures can be really opened up, where students, I think we've been focusing on design a little too much for last maybe 50 years, and it's time to really look at research almost as an equal component of our architecture studios, so that you know, students go out of institutions like these thinking that it's not simply my whims and fancies which govern design, but design is born out of a very intense process of research, understanding different aspects of built space and different aspects of society, culture, because architecture really is an overlaying of so many different layers of, you know, things. For example, you need to look at how people live, where they study, what are their income backgrounds, how are buildings serviced, where is the water being discharged, where is the water coming from, how much do you consume. So, a lot of layers. And at the end of that, you also need to make something aesthetic. You have to make something culturally relevant. So, it's a very complex subject. And I think one of the, I would say, some kind of a baggage we got from our modern masters was that design is some kind of a me, myself, and I kind of an idea, and that's something which we need to now really, through institutions, start to underplay and look at design born out of very intense process of research. So I would, you know, that's what my recommendation is. I wouldn't say too much about what the state of education is, because clearly there are so many things which are going wrong in different institutions, and you know, one can only suggest that where we should start to fix things in that manner. And that's my suggestion, that we really need to look at architecture not as something which is some kind of a germination of an idea alone, but something which is born out of a great process of research, something which comes out of urban research, typological research, etc.
Thank you so much. Can you give a message to the students at SOAP at Goenka University?
So I think for students, you know, it's so much fun to be student with students, and I wish I was going to say it's so much fun to be students, and I wish I was a student all my life, because you know, you really start to understand the value of being a student when you cannot be a student. So really, I would say for the students is that institutions are just the beginning of education. So unfortunately, we all tend to believe that when we go to an institution and pass out of an institution, we've got it all. But that's completely wrong. And I think, really speaking, you know, in the last 20, 25 years after passing out of an institution, I've realized that institution is just a trigger and you have to stay inspired. The search is always personal. The search is something which you have to imbibe. You have to get from inside of you. And do not think that, you know, to pass out of a college, you are now, you have arrived or you have made it all, because institutions like these will only be a platform for you to really take off. It's not the end of education. It's really the beginning of education. So if your parents have been telling you that education ends when you pass out of this university, they're completely wrong. It really starts when you go out there, because until now you've been in some kind of a cocoon, which is either a school or a university or an institution. And now there will be a new kind of education, which is when you will go out into the field, into the practice. And this practice may not necessarily be a conventional architectural office practice that I'm trying to imply, but the entire world is your playground now. The entire world is the institution. You have to learn from nature. You have to learn from communities. You have to learn from all around you. So, and you can read about it all through. All great men have been the ones, you know, a lot of people who are successful in institutions may not turn out to be the most successful outside institutions. And most people who weren't very successful in institutions actually turned out to be very successful and inspiring leaders in our society, and not only in India, but all over the world. And so many examples you can see all across the world. I mean, I wouldn't want to name any one of them, but really you have to all stay inspired. You have to always look at more than what is being taught or imparted, you know, in a studio in a literal sense. So, you know, institutions will always have shortcomings. They will have some things which will be good, some things will be bad, but the search is all yours and you have to pursue on and really be at it with a great amount of intensity to figure out your path. Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.